This is Scott Crothers. Happy Thanksgiving, Scott. Thanks for checking back in.
Hey, happy Thanksgiving to you, McGraw.
On Friday, I know it was a very slow day, but the markets can't be closed for more than 3 days in a row, so the market had to open up on Friday. Slow trading day, but we were up on Friday, 31 points. Anything of note happened on Friday?
Yes, Friday the Dow was up 32 points and closed at 23,558 in a light day of trading. It was a half day with markets closed at noon and no major economic data released. Technology was strong as it has been all year, but we are also seeing a year-end rally in consumer stocks. The yield on the 10-year U.S. Treasury was flat at 2.34%.
All right, let's get to some news. What about the sales going on this holiday season?
Yeah, well, the U.S. What was it? Well, several retailers are saying their holiday sales are getting off to a great start. Kohl's had a record-breaking Thanksgiving, and JCPenney had the most hits. Macy said they will sell 1 million coats, fleece jackets, and sweaters over the weekend. So over $5 billion was spent online by the end of Friday, up 17% from a year ago.
Coats? Who's buying coats? It's 70 degrees outside.
I guess they think it's going to get cold, McGraw.
Yeah, all right, good. I didn't get your email today. Anything else of note I should ask you about?
Sure. Meredith, the owner of Better Homes and Gardens, is buying Time for $1.85 billion. Time publishes its namesake magazine as well as People, Sports Illustrated, and Fortune. The deal is for $18.50 per share and the assumption of debt and has been approved by both boards. The combined company will reach about 200 million people.
Yeah. Also, I think they published the magazine. More importantly, they published the magazine Wood, which is a very important magazine, much more important than all those other ones.
Big magazine for McGraw-Miller.
Yes. This is going to affect my life, which is why it is very important. I just want to know if they're going to expand the pages of Wood magazine. Go ahead, Scott.
Oh, yeah. Also, the U.S. stock markets keep hitting new highs this year, but most of the world's markets are doing well also. Half of the 35 major indices around the world are hitting new highs, including the U.K., India, Japan, and South Korea. Ironically, China is in a bear market while its neighbors are doing well. Also, only 13 countries are in a recession, the lowest level in over a decade. So that's all good news.
Yeah, all great. All right, how do the markets look today on the first day after Thanksgiving?
Well, today the Dow looks flat as we get off to a very busy week. We get a look at the housing market, GDP, and consumer confidence this week. We do not have the big employment report on Friday, although it is the first Friday of the month. Furthermore, this week we expect Jay Powell to be confirmed as the new Fed chair on Tuesday. So,
all right, lots of news going up, and you'll fill us all in throughout the week. Scott Crothers, have yourself a good day. Thanks for checking in.